This logarithmic method says 5395 above it is obtained and having a target till 56417. 5368 below it is a downtrend and it has a maximum target as per the Fibonacci is 6346. However, yearly terms the volatility is 10.53. Can anyone will tell me whether it is advisable to trade in the Nifty future today or not? Many of you are using my concept, many of you are using the software also. With this volatility of 10.52%, now is it possible, is it good to trade in this? Majority of the people, those who are using this concept, I may name few, Mr. Anup Agrawal, Mr. Muralidhar, Mr. Nilesh Narya, Mr. Madhu, and many, Mr. Ruben William, Mr. Venugopal, and many out of this 100 odd people, many of you, those who are using, they are saying that no. Yes, it is pretty acceptable that whenever we are having a less than or near to 10% volatility, better to avoid the trade. Trade cannot be done with impulse. Trade cannot be done with your means impulse that yes, I want to snatch something from the market. So here, thing is that this is a very low volatility condition. So for this reason, better to avoid in the Nifty. Look into the Bank Nifty. So daily volatility, annual terms it is 25, and it is giving these are the levels for the Bank Nifty for today. Annual terms 25, pretty good. You can think of trading in the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty is currently quoting at 1236, 12,036. 12,036. I am expecting below 12,000, I must sell it for 11,900. Above 12,123, I may buy it for 12,123, I may buy it for 12,222. This is for Bank Nifty. I may not shout today because I have some throat infections. So this is the levels in front of your screen. So you can very well record these numbers. Again, coming back to the State Bank of India, I am just as per the volatility 1905 above, we are expecting 1920. Annual terms volatility is 24%. Below 1886, we are expecting 1872. This is as per the current volatility intact in this. Currently, SBI future is 1883 level. Bank Nifty and SBI future, both are not given us the breakout. Same way, I will be going for Infosys. Infosys, annual terms, the volatility is 8.43. Henceforth, I will rule out the tradings in this because my volatility is way below 10%, which is not giving me a comfort zone. Even though if I enter to the trade, I cannot make the profit. Let the volatility to enhance to a bit, then only I can make some trades on this. So this is what I have told you. And one thing I will just come back to here. Suppose Bank Nifty, I am telling you to insert a trade. So at 12,000 and keeping a stop loss of 12,122. Many of you, those who are new to this concept, many of you, this is the stop loss for the sell trade and for the buy trade, this is the stop loss. So many of you saying that keep taking a dip of 122 points is a very weak because my profitability is around some 100 points. So how come I will take all 122 point risk? So as I said to you, this method, manually I have not fixed it. Manually I have not said that yes, I should use this method. In fact, GAN is very much appreciable in this particular situation. We can use GAN's concept. However, if the stop loss is deep enough and it is giving me certain view that yes, even though my stop loss triggers, I'll be at a loss and that loss will be very deep impacting loss. even though I got the full profit, I have the equal 1:1, sometime 1:0.5 also risk reward. So risk reward is not a concept at all in the intraday trade, but to make you understand, I am just telling you this is a risk reward. So in this case, if I sell this one, nothing wrong if I can just buy a 12,100 call option. It is the way I can protect. 12,100 call option I can buy at with the sell trade so that I can protect the trade without diluting the concept of volatility, without diluting the very principle of Fibonacci. I can just hedge my trade for the intraday. So what happens, even though if I trigger the stop loss, out of this 122 points, my call option could have appreciated to a bit and I will just get some lesser impact on the stop loss. Same way, even though if I achieve all 100% of the things, my profitability at 100 point, maybe some 30, 40 points or 50 points, I will lose out of this thing. So I can think of this. But one thing you have to keep in mind very carefully. Hedging with the future and option buy. This is the option we are buying with the to hedge the future. This thing is only permissible whenever you are at a medium or low volatile market. If you are at a high volatile market, like above 40% of the volatility, if you are hedging with the option, that option will have a greater time value decay and that trade will not reward you anything for intraday. So see, it is hedging with a buying side option is always permissible whenever you are in a medium or low volatile market. If you are a high volatile market, then how you can hedge? Instead of buying a call option here, you can sell the future and sell a put option of 12,000. So it is a high volatile, some time value decay in intraday basis you will come. If stop loss comes also, you will get some profit and come out. So this is for daily volatility you need to calculate. So this is what for the Nifty, Bank Nifty and Nifty we are ruling out. Bank Nifty and SBI I'm recommending to enter the trade, and in fact I'm not recommending the trade in the Infosys because that is having a damn low volatility for today. So this is what you got for the things for three trades now. But this one uses some of the enhanced methodology to calculate the volatility. It uses Fibonacci, Gann and Elliott dynamically based on its volatility condition, means less than 20 and less than 40 and above 40. So above 40 based on this condition, and it can be used in equity futures and equity future index currency. Also we have given a separate interface for the commodities. So commodities we have made a separate interface. Same concept also we have inherited in the options. So let me move into the directly into the options so that you can have a look into the option and future both. So this also same concept we have inherited for the options. So I am taking the index future. Nifty is damn low. I am not taking Nifty at all. So I am just going for the Bank Nifty. Yes, it is having a very low volatility. If the volatility improves, then I may rethink on the Nifty, but currently I will not venture into the Nifty. So now I will just analyze the future first. It says that 1257 above my trend, because it uses a different method for calculating your volatility. So volatility has come to 25.58. 1257 above, it is telling me uptrend. 11,976 below, it is telling me the downtrend. But logarithmic method was different. This is giving you somewhat different values because of its different style of working on the volatility. Also, it takes the intraday price parameter into account. till 940, what is the price parameter? That also it takes into account. So let me evaluate for 12,000, because if it is 12,100 is the nearest strike for the call option. So let me take for the 12,100 call option, which is 256 now. So 256, 12,000 call option. So option index, Bank Nifty, 12,100 I have taken. Call option, so 256 we have tracked. Now it is 260 level. So 260 level, analyze the option now. So here, implied volatility of the option is 26%, volatility of the underlying asset is 25%, so well within the band of 30% differences. And it is the current delta and other things it has given us. It is telling you to buy at 277, keeping a stop loss at 237. These are the targets for the day. If it goes to 12,223, then you may expect 365. If you are selling at 237 with a stop loss of 277, and if it is falling down to 11,810, your option will come down to 159. So currently you are at a 260 level. So record this trade and see what happens during the day. So once we are getting a trend breakout, that time only we will enter the trade. So I'll be futures levels for Bank Nifty, options level for the Bank Nifty. We never know which side the trend will give us the breakout. So this I am saving it. So for our future reference, we'll save it. So, and one more thing also you are getting here. Option arbitrage, that I have not spoken for a long time. Option arbitrage facility also you are getting here. So for that, I'll be uploading the 12,000 call option. I'll be uploading the 11,900 call option. I'll also upload the 12,200 call option and 12,300 call option. So I'll just check it with the fair value parameter. I'll just reduce this screen. I'll brought it right hand side. So this says 12,200 call option, which is 213 now. So 213 I am getting. So let me change the pen color so that. So 213 is the price. So almost fair value is 12, it is 13. Slightly it is 1 or 2 rupees difference. 12,300, 169, 173 or 74. So 170 to 73. So this is only plus 3 rupees is the mispriced. minus 3 rupees is the mispriced. You expect 174. It is at 170 level, so 4 rupees is the mispriced. 12,000, you are expecting 307, it is at 300 level. In fact, 12,100 also fallen now. So 11,900, you are expecting 364, you are at 361. So it almost 2 or 3 rupees difference, so it doesn't make any sense now to trade with that. So rather, let us see some put options. So if I am just, let me load data freshly, because the data points has changed. So data points has changed. Analyze future and analyze option. So put option, I'll be choosing 12,000, same 12,000, let me take 11,974, I am taking 12,000 put option, 291, analyze option, here also 25, 32, these are the levels, 308 it is telling you to buy once the downtrend starts, 386 it is giving you that levels, 272 you can keep the stop loss for the trade, once the trend is giving you the breakout then only you can do, at same time also see the arbitrage opportunity if any. So we will be just putting some of the arbitrage here. It is the 12,000 put option. this is the put option. So I am just taking for put option. I have selected 12,000 put option, 11,900 put option, 11,800 put option. I have taken also 12,100 put option and 12,200 put option. 12,200 put option. And this is the levels we have got it. And just see what is the fair value and other parameters. 12,200. You are expecting 395, 399. So almost it is having same value, 95 to 99. Bid is 96. Offer is 400. So 5 to 6 rupees, 1 or 2 rupees. If you can increase the bid also, you can get it. But almost it is fair. 12,100. 340. So 340 also you may get it. 11,800. 205 is the fair value. You are getting some 230. So here you are getting 8 rupees excess value. 11,900 also having some excess value of 7 rupees. 7 rupees excess value. This is having 8 rupees. This is having 7 rupees as their excess value. So this is 7 rupees excess value, this is 8 rupees excess value, and these two are fairly priced or almost in their fair price. So if I can think in this term, this 8 rupees in 25 is coming to 25 into 8. So 200 rupees it is coming. 200 rupees it is coming. This 200 rupees, if you want to materialize, you can think of selling 11,800 put option, sell, if you think that 200 rupees I can materialize, and buy 12,000 put option, which is at a fair price. So when the market will come to the downside, like 11,808 maximum, or if it is closing below first or second target of your this level, then you can encash this 200 rupees of mispricing. And since it is a low volatile scenario, it is a consolidation phase, you are experiencing somewhat lesser value in this mispricing. Whenever there is a good amount of volatility is there, when the speculations is more in the market or the speculators are more in the market, you can get some good mispricing in this option. So this is a concept also you can implement in your intraday trade, especially in options, identifying the mispricing the options, option which is overpriced, sell it off, and option which is underpriced, buy it off at a trend breakout point. The rule is trend breakout point. It must give you the breakout at 11,974, then only you should initiate this or else not. Once the trend has given you the breakout, that point, if you identify breakout in the downward direction, if you identify any mispricing in the put options, then initiate. If the trend is giving you breakout in the upside direction and you are identifying some of the mispricing in the call options, then you can think of initiating the option arbitrage trade in the call options. So this is also a fantastic technique which can help you to do a high volume trade in intraday trade, which can help you to protect your money also, which can help you to make some money out of speculation in a very scientific way. So this also you can think of initiating. So trades in this. State Bank of India equity. So this also I am just saving this experiment for our future reference. So I am saving this experiment for our. So I am going for ICICI Bank. Now, equities but whenever you are doing in intraday trade you must, so this is what it is saying, probability of falling down is more, going up is less, but pretty better than the SBI, and this is the level for this print screen I have given you. So here two counters we have taken for equity segment, we can take one for currency also, USDINR. USDINR, this is the level for the USDINR. So USDINR, this is the level, probability of going up is pretty good, and you can think of so if your probability are almost equal, then you have equal chances. So this is for the currency future. I'm just saving this thing also for you, one for currency future. So this all things we are just taking. So index future, what it recommends for the Nifty, what it recommends for the Nifty, just you have to select the symbol, just load data and calculate. So this is what you have to do. So this is the entry levels it is giving. Going up is 78 to 79 points. It is 79% it is giving based on the current parameters. Sell entry, buy entry it is also giving. And uptrend, downtrend, price points also it is giving. So this also, save this one. But Nifty you may not get much success for the day. Reason, it has a very low volatility. So that also, whenever you have a very low volatility also, it impacts, and it says that probability of going up is very high. So this is for Nifty. Bank Nifty already you have seen. So some stock futures, why not Infi, some rapid sorts we are doing, some of the, whenever you are doing for any future trade based on the trend, take the help of maximum utilization of the options must be done. So here also low volatility, that also contributes to the probability of going up. So one thing also I'll tell you, whenever this probability of going up is showing you more than 70%, not 60, more than 70%, so that time little bit 70%, so little bit have some greater than 70%, have a look on their volatility. Sometimes the low volatility also going to impact on their probability. So that one indicator we will also put it in the thing, since I have identified today this behavior. So Infosys is having a less than 10% of volatility, and it is showing a probability of going up is 82. So that is because of its low volatility, because we used to say that whenever there is a low volatility, price upward trend is maximum. So based on that concept, it is giving you certain kind of pulse level, so of rising and falling. So I will rectify it immediately. Today post session I will tell my programmers to rectify it. This may be due to the low volatility also. So whenever you are just trading in the futures, take the help of options also. Very judiciously you take the help of options also. This is for Infi. So this is the quite few levels we have just made it or calculated it. So let us see what happens during the day. But again and again, it is my request to all of you, do not excessively indulge in the intraday. Think somewhat progressive, think somewhat more rational, think to protect your capital, and यू मस्ट टेक वेरी लो लेवरेज और वेरी लो एक्सपोजर इन टू द इंट्राडे एज फार एज इट इज पॉसिबल. इट इज नॉट बैड टू डू द इंट्राडे ट्रेड, बट इफ यू हैव 50,000 कैपिटल टेकिंग 5 लाख रिस्क विथ द ब्रोकर्स एक्सपोजर एंड एंटरिंग इट, देन इट इज रॉन्ग. एक्सेप्ट दैट फैक्ट्स इनिशियली. एंड वन मोर थिंग अबाउट द इंट्राडे ऑल्सो, इवन दो इफ यू आर इन द फ्यूचर सेगमेंट, इफ यू आर इन्वॉल्व इन इंट्राडे, बेटर टू यूज एनी सॉफ्टवेयर यू यूज, एनी कॉन्सेप्ट यू यूज, यूज द ऑप्शंस विद दैट. सो इफ द इम्पैक्ट कम्स, इफ द लॉसेस और स्टॉप लॉसेस हैज कम्स, देन यू कैन गेट सम इंडिया So if the impact comes also, you'll be little protected on that. And one more thing, very carefully you observe this VIX. Whenever you are getting this VIX, it's less than 17%. Try to avoid the intraday trade, either in the stock, future, whatever may be. Try to avoid the intraday trade, because most of the intraday trade will produce negative return in those VIX parameter if it is less than 7. Comfortably you can do the trade if it is above 20% VIX. So that also have a look, very close look in this. So only thing is that protections. Only thing is that protection.